better understand. To my heart I must be true. Oh, you're the one that I want. If you're feeling some affection, that's too hard.
Okay, we keep working, we keep rolling. Have we got camera up? We're going into it. Like there's no difference. There's no difference between working and life. We can't tell the difference. No one can tell when we're actually shooting and when we're actually living.
The question about why I blur the lines between life and art, and where does my life stop and where does the art begin? I mean, you know, I think both Sim and I, my wife Catherine Martin and I, there's no job for us, and my family, and my extended circus family, there's no job, there's just the art. There's no, we start at 9, we finish at 5. It is part of our life, and everything we do just without even trying moves without effort from the reality of our life to the fiction of our work. And they do cross-fertilize and they do segue into each other.
We work in a number of different ways. Initially, Baz, who's an extremely visual director, will do a lot of tear sheets, so he'll pull a lot from magazines. Often we create these sort of quite complicated, half-drawn, half-Photoshop boards that will try and express the mood of any given moment within the film. Slowly throughout the process, Baz will start to make what we call an animatic of all those images. He'll say, I want a board of Gisele doing this, and we'll start to put together all these crazy images so that he can get a sense of how the work is actually going to evolve visually. I might sketch something, someone might be finding references, we'll put them all together, Baz will draw over the top, we'll go and change them again. It's a very liquid process between us providing images, Baz creating storyboards, our editor moving footage references, and they all get put together in a big editing pot. And that dialogue keeps going, I think much to everyone's frustration, up until hours before we actually start shooting.
I think it's probably true that the nature of directing is the nature of controlling at least a little part of the world. I actually create an environment where I hope the actors can flourish. I see it as my job to create an environment where they can play. The truth is, children act brilliantly because children play. We're called players. It's called a play. It's play acting. It's very hard to play if you're scared. And so my job is to remove fear from the environment and let players play, and also to capture the play. I got into the swimming pool and I got the camera and I marked out an area to work out that when I got back with Gisele, would she be able to actually do with the board what I hoped would be her entrance into the little film? Now, the reason I do it, rather than just say to a stand-in do it, is that I want to be able to go to an actor and say, you know it can work, it will be all right. She's not as tough.
Okay.
She's more vulnerable. More vulnerable. I feel I'm the actor's representative, and I need to be able to say, well, I can do it, so it's all right. If you don't understand what they're going through, you know, the lights, the costume, the noise, the distraction, how can I help them play?